Hello, beautiful souls. It's Karen here at Soul Magic Inspiration and Star Child Tarot. And I'm here with the lunar eclipse energies. So the lunar eclipse is on the 28th of October, and it's in Taurus, one of the earth signs. So before we get the messages, I want you to pick a pile. But first, I want to say a big thank you. Appreciate your love and support. I've just released my third ebook, which is called Shades of Love. It's a book of love poetry. It's now available on Amazon. It's £3.60 to purchase. So check that out. The links are down below. I have two other books. I also have a deck shop. I have a Patreon page from just £2 a month. And there is still a competition right now until the end of August. Sorry, I don't know what I said, August, end of October, to win a free reading. Just comment the word love. Okay, so we've got three piles. So before we get into the piles, just tell you a little bit about the eclipse. So the lunar eclipse, this is a new moon. So we've just been through the solar eclipse, which was, sorry, this is a full moon. Sorry, we just went through the solar eclipse, which is a new moon. This is a full moon. So this is about releasing, and it's time to make improvements in our life. To look at our lives to see what we need to change. This energy is also can really make us look at relationships, about the polarities in our life, and trying to find balance between our earthly desires and earthly matters and the mysteries of life, our spiritual aspect. It's time to take care of yourself and your needs. It's time to be passionate. It's a creative time. And intimate relationships could come to the forefront at this time, and it's a really good time to express your feelings. If there's any crisis that comes up, it's a time to explore your own emotional needs at this time. What is triggering you? What do you need to heal? And to let go of any old patterns in your life. This lunar eclipse can also bring hidden things to the surface. So this could be feelings, this could be secrets. And it's a need, a time you're feeling the need to have your own needs met. And it's the time to come to self-realization and to take care of yourself first before giving to others. And very much a time of releasing, release what no longer serves you, and allow room for the new to come in. Okay, so let's look at the fire piles. So pile one, we have the witch. Pile two, eternal love. And pile three, pick it up, apple. So pick what resonates for you and we'll get your messages. I have pre-shuffled the oracles. We're going to look at those first and then we're going to get the tarot messages at the end. Okay, so let's start with pile one. So we have the witch, the earthly weaver of the worlds. So maybe some of you do resonate in this energy. Maybe you like to do spells. Maybe you make potions, lotions, or there's just like a witchiness about you. Maybe other people have commented. And this is the time of the year with the Halloween, where the veil is thinner, and you could have psychic gifts in some way. You could have, clairs, clairsentient, claircognizant. You could be highly intuitive. You're very in touch with your inner self, your intuition. But you're also a very down-to-earth person as well, and very grounded. So there's a balance. There is a balance, or you're working on that balance between, being in that spiritual energy, but also being down-to-earth and grounded. And I feel it's encouraging you to do that even more right now. We have graveyard, unnecessary fear, RIP. So, some of you could be going through fear. You could be in a fear energy right now. There's a lot in the community, collective, there's a lot in the world. There's some awful things happening in the world, in different parts of the world, to many, 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 many millions of people. And maybe you're in that fear energy yourself, And it's time to let go of the fear, because fear is the opposite of love. And try and get into the energy of love, you know, connect with your heart space, connect with your feelings. And it's more proactive to send loving energy to others at this time that are suffering, that are going through things. And fear keeps us frozen, and fear, false evidence appearing real. Some things that you think are real are not real, and we can blow up things. We can have these irrational fears around things in our life, situations, or people, and sometimes they are irrational. But we need to try and balance that out and really get into the energy of love. So, if you're feeling fearful right now, I would suggest you try and get into your heart space, focus on loving yourself and sending out love to everyone who needs it in the world. You know, having that unconditional love in your heart, it will really, dissipate the fear within you. And we've got the moon and soul energy number two. So this could be talking about soulmate energy. That's, the color green, like the heart chakra there. Number two, there could be a soulmate energy coming into your life. But I feel this is also you connecting with your soul, maybe your soul's purpose, your soul's mission. But being in that energy of self-love, the greenie of the heart chakra, really focusing on you. And, maybe you're very sensitive to the moon energies. You're very sensitive. You're sensitive. You're highly empathetic. So honor that about yourself. There are actually gifts that can help you navigate in the world. And we have the sun. So we do have the sun and the moon. So again, that could be divine counterpart energy. The sun being the masculine, the moon being the feminine. But this could also, as we said at the beginning, talking about you balancing your energies. But it could also mean there is a soulmate energy coming towards you. You're balancing each other out, the sun and the moon. And we have the number one, and that's number two. So there is, it does feel synchronicity here, and we've got spirit. So yeah, it does feel like there could be a spiritual connection coming towards you. And as you get out of that fear energy and you open up to love, I feel that you're going to manifest that into your life. You're going to attract somebody who's in the same energy as you. And this is destined, I feel, somebody that you were destined to meet. And we've got the energy of gratitude. I'm thankful for this life and the opportunities that it presents. So being in that gratitude energy, is a good way to attract more to be a grateful for. Grateful for where you're at, grateful for what you have, grateful for the people around you, grateful for the blessings that you already have in your life. And, try and keep a gratitude diary and be aware and, have that gratitude in your heart, and that will really increase the flow around you and in your life. And we've got abundance. I'm a limitless being and I can manifest whatever I desire in this physical reality. So again, they go hand in hand, I feel. As you become more grateful, it becomes easier for you to manifest abundance, and all the things that you're trying to manifest will come in. It's connecting to that flow, really tapping into that flow of life, of being for grateful for where we're at, for what we have right now, and opening up to receive and manifesting your desires. Yeah, we've got fear come up again. So yeah, it could be particularly, you could be feeling particularly fearful right now. Excuse me, there could be something going on in your life that is really triggering fear. Sometimes we have these triggers, don't we, in life that trigger us to fear, to feel fearful, to feel anxious, to feel worried. And I know it's easy for me to say, but we need to try and connect with our heart space and really get into our loving feelings, to feel the love, because love is the opposite to fear. And when you're in that fear-based energy, you're not in that loving energy, and you deserve to have that love, your own love, that self-love. And obviously, once you're in that energy, you can love others even more. And that spreads the love around the world, which is what we want. We want more love energy and less fear energy. Yeah, we've got realization number three. So this is like a keyhole. If you look at that, it's like a keyhole. There could be you're unlocking something, okay, within you, I feel. Unlocking something, some knowing, some understanding of who you are and what your purpose is. And it's really going to widen your horizons, because as she looks through there, you can see, and coming into the light, out of a dark period. As I say, you could have been in very much fear-based energy, going through Dark Night of the Soul even, but the sun is shining through the keyhole, you can see that. So I feel that you're going to be widening your horizons, and as you do that, your life will get brighter and brighter. You know, better things are coming towards you. And then we have the sun. Wow, new beginnings, just number one. A leap of faith. So sun in Aries. Aries is ruled by Mars, which is the action planet. So sometimes we need to take action in our lives. We need to take that leap of faith to trust that all will be well, okay, that we are supported. We are supported by the universe, our guides, our angels. There's a new beginning waiting for you. And the sun is going to shine, and you're going to have the joy, the sun, and it's the balance of masculine and feminine, because we've got the orange of the sacral and we've got the yellow of the solar plexus, which is the masculine and feminine. So as you balance your energies, as I say, you're getting ready for a new beginning, and the sun is going to shine in your life. Much more happier times coming towards you. Yeah, we've got summer, number one plus three, which is a four. So, you know, whenever I see that card, it's about manifestation to me, you know, summoning your desires, you know, and we've got the witch at the beginning. Maybe you do use magic, you know, maybe you Wiccan, or you do some sort of spell work, candle work, you manifest with the moon energies, whatever you do. I feel you're going to be summoning your desires, you're going to be manifesting your desires. So be careful what you focus on what you do want as opposed to what you don't want right now. And we've got Earth Star activation, anchoring, grounded action, Isis energy. So you could be very connected with Goddess Isis, you know, an ancient goddess from Egypt, who was all about resurrection. I mean, the story goes that her husband was murdered and, you know, cut into pieces, basically. It's quite a graphic story. But she put him back together, magical alchemy. So this could be you know, you could put things back together, you could mend things that are broken with your energy, but you need to get anchored into Mother Gaia. You need to do any grounding exercise, and we've got the Earth Star chakra, which is above the crown chakra there, that connection to the divine, to the universe. So you could be increasing that connection, but we need to get grounded, so anchoring our energy to Earth before we activate this energy. And connecting with the divine, for, you know, divine guidance, and to make sure we're balanced, you know, as above, so below. So, I've got two final guidance cards, which we're going to get at the end. So we're going to get some tarot. So what lunar eclipse energies do we have for pile one? Which, and I'm using the witch's tarot. So which lunar, sorry, what lunar eclipse energies for pile one? What are the energies for pile one? For the highest light and love, what are the energies? We've got nine of pentacle energy, so that's you being independent, you know, not needy, not codependent, feeling good, feeling abundant in your own energy, you know, not wanting or needing a relationship, you know, feeling good on your own, like that sovereign energy, feeling good on your own. What other energies for pile one? Yeah, we've got the Death card. So, you know, it's ruled by Scorpio, transformation. So we can see you're going through a transformation here from being fear-based to more love, heart-centered. And then we have the Knight of Cups energy. So I feel as you get into that heart-centered energy, you're manifesting this connection, I feel, as I said. And we've got the Knight of Cups energy. So somebody who could be younger than you, somebody romantic, somebody fun to be around, but they have love to offer you. They have love to offer you. What other energies? Yeah, we have Two of Cups. So this is going to be mutual. This is a mutual connection, as I said at the beginning. I feel it feels like soulmate energy. What else for pile one? Yeah, it's about taking that leap of faith, you know. And having that new beginning, you know, there could be a message coming through with the Page of Pentacles, some sort of communication, and around that you could be taking a leap of faith, as I said. And we got the Empress energy. So you being in that receptive energy, being open to receive all good, will bring that into your life, as I said. So let's get your final guidance. So your guides want you to know you and your loved ones are safe. You've got Cancer energy. So some of you could be Cancer. You're very much in your feelings right now. This could be why you're fearful. Maybe you're really worried about your family in some way or something else in your life. But they want you to know that you are safe. You and your loved ones are safe. That's a reassurance from spirit. And expect powerful change. Look at that new moon eclipse. So although this isn't the new moon, it's the full moon. But there is powerful change. You can see that there. So I'm going to leave it there, pile one. Love and blessings. Hello, pile two. Let's look at your card. So you've got eternal love. Love is love is love. And it transcends physical death. So maybe some of you have got this connection with somebody, or it could be you've lost a loved one. And if you have, I'm so sorry for your loss. But any love that we feel for others, you know, even if we lose them in the physical, that connection is still there. They're always in your heart, okay, whatever the situation. But I feel this could be a love relationship because we got the two there. Okay, so it could be a special person that you're maybe separated from right now. Or this is somebody you've lost, and you know, I'm sorry for that. So let's go a bit deeper. And we've got zombie control. Wow. So, yeah, maybe you know you have been through a loss and you felt a bit like a zombie. Maybe you felt like you're just going through the motions. You feel numb. You don't feel anything because you're afraid to feel your feelings. And you're trying to control everything because you know you've been through this awful situation, whether it was the loss of a loved one or whatever happened to you, something that triggered this feeling that you need to control everything and not feeling awake, not feeling fully alive in some way. And I feel that you're coming out of this, okay? You're going to be coming out of this energy because the lunar eclipse is all about that, okay? It's all about releasing and letting go. And allowing ourselves to move forward. And yeah, Aries, I am number one plus three, which is a four. So some of you could be Aries, fire sign, ruled by Mars, or you're just going to be coming into that energy. As I said, after that control energy, I am taking charge, you know, being in that self-aware energy, taking control of your life, you know, very much the action planet Aries, ruled by Mars. Very much about taking action. So I feel you're going to start moving forward with that energy. And number four is feeling more grounded. One plus three, four is that grounded energy, foundational energy. So after feeling shaky on shaky ground after a loss or whatever happened, you're going to start feeling more grounded, more settled, more safe. And you're going to start moving forward, you know, or getting in touch with yourself more, knowing who you truly are. Really get into the depths of who you are. And we've got self node, life's debts, number four plus two, so six, the energy of love for me. So that there could be, you know, karmic lessons that you've been going through. There could be actual money worries, money struggles in your life. And again, I feel that's all going to be released. I feel there's a change coming in with that. The self node is about the past. Okay, so you're letting go of these worries, these debts, you know, whether they be physical debts or whether they're karmic debts. I feel you've done work on yourself and you're going to be letting go of those energies. We've got patience. I accept that everything happens in divine order. So I feel that you've had to very much learn patience in your life with the situation that you've been in, especially with money worries. Or not feeling alive, you know, going through a loss or whatever that was, difficult times. And you've learnt patience. You've had to learn patience and trust and faith here. So it was a big lesson. And we've got empathy. I'm open to seeing both sides of a situation. So you're very empathetic. And again, this could have really helped you grow your empathy. To really get in touch with that empathy, you know, if you suffered a loss of somebody, whether, you know, whether it be a physical loss or somebody, you know, had a breakup, you know, a romantic breakup, something like that. And maybe you were not seeing things clearly and now being able to see things from the other person's point of view, having that empathy and understanding from their perspective as well as yourself. Yeah, faith. So again, having that renewed faith, number four, So I've got 4-4, which is like heavily connected with Archangel Michael. And Archangel Michael, the powerful Archangel, you can use his energy, his sword, to cut through the BS, to, illuminate the truth. You can use his sword to disconnect you, like cord cutting with others that drag you down. You can also use him to protect you if you feel unsafe or unsure of where you're at. You can use his energy. You can call on him to assist you at any time. And we've got hunger at 29, so I've got 11. So, again, I feel like twin flame energy here from this pile. So you could be in separation, but the love is always there, the connection is always there, whether you're together in the physical. And you could really feel in this passion, this desire for this person right now. This moon energy could really accentuate it. But I also feel it's a passion for life, that hunger, that renewed passion when you're in a zombie state. So you're going to be getting coming into that renewed passion and energy with the Aries to, move forward in life, to create your life, to follow your passions. Yeah, we've got accomplishment, moon in Capricorn, and we've got 22, which again, to me, talks of relationships. Scale main mountains to gain a sense of achievement. So I feel possibly you have been doing that in your life, okay? You have been scaling mountains. You've been through a lot, okay, in your life, whatever scenario that resonates for you. You've literally, it's felt like you've had to climb mountains. To regain that sense of balance, that sense of self again, especially if you've gone through some sort of loss, okay, it can take a while, obviously, to gain our equilibrium, our stability, but you always had that faith and you also had that passion inside you, and I feel that's going to be reborn, and you're going to feel a sense of accomplishment of how far you've come. And the fledgling, number one. So again, new beginning energy. And after every ending is a new beginning. And with that fledgling, I can't say it. Fledgling energy, I feel you're being asked to try new things, not be afraid to be new at something, not to tr be afraid to try new things or go new places. Be a new version of you. You could be coming into a new version of you after this period, a transformational energy very, very strongly here. And we have crystal skull wisdom. Clarity, divine healing, high vibrational energy. So I don't know if you know the story of the crystal skulls. There is a great book about it. I can't remember the name who it's by now. But the legend is that there's 13 crystal skulls throughout the world. Some have been discovered, and they hold ancient wisdom and knowledge of humanity. And when they come together, the knowledge will be revealed, and some people can communicate with them telepathically. You can also buy little crystal skulls as well, like little crystals that you might connect with telepathically as well. Or just having some sort of quartz crystal, some sort of clear crystal could really help you with your healing. Again, you could get healing with that, or you could receive messages through that energy. But open up to receiving messages from the divine, and also open up to receive healing and open up to get into that higher vibrational energy, which I feel that you are doing now. You're going to be doing that. So we've got some guidance messages for the end. So meantime, we're going to get our tarot. And this is the Santa Marta Tarot. It's an absolutely gorgeous deck. Yeah, we've got Queen of Swords that just flew out. So Queen of Swords energy. So you could be an air sign, Aquarius, Libra, Gemini, or you're in that energy. So normally, the Queen of Swords has a sword across her, like shielding her, protecting her. This figure has the sword on her shoulders. So I feel that you're putting down your barriers, or you're opening up more. Your guard is a bit down, and you are open now. I feel you're open, but you're still somebody that's going to speak your truth, I feel. Yeah, we've got judgment energy here. So, we saw that patience there. So anything that you've done, anything that you've put out there, good deeds, are going to come back, return to you. Judgment energy. So what else for pile two about this eclipse? Got Knight of Pentacles. So this could be that person, like I said at the beginning, that I felt you in separation from somebody. Could be an earth sign, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, but doesn't have to be. Somebody younger than you, somebody that's taken their time. Maybe you've been in separation for quite a long time. And they've taken their time, but when they do arrive, if this resonates for you, it will be solid. They want to make a solid commitment to this. Okay, it's not flighty energy at all. What else for pile two about the eclipse? What else do they need to know? Well, we've got the Emperor energy. So I was picking up that divine counterpart energy. So this Emperor, as I always say, he's battle worn. He's literally lost half his leg there. He's been through a lot, okay? And I'm not saying that you haven't either as a divine feminine, if I assume you're the divine feminine watching this. But somebody's coming towards you. They've been through a lot in their own life. They've been through a lot like you. Okay, they could have suffered losses as well. And they're battle worn, but they are coming towards you in that Emperor energy. They've done that work. Yeah, we've got Three of Wands. So this is all about the timing. This is divine timing. So I feel that when you're both in that energy, in the right energy, when you both finish doing your healing, and we've got the Ten of Cups. So there is the offer of a relationship here, as I said. Death card, as I said, with the Emperor, he's really done that work on himself to get into that energy. We've got the transformational energy here, the Death card. So, really going from one phase to a new phase. Anything else? Anything else that pile two needs to know about this eclipse? We have the Sun. So I feel there's much happier times coming ahead for you. Okay, the Sun is going to start shining in your life again. So let's get some final guidance. So emotions are running high. Yeah, emotions could be running high, especially if there's a reunion on the cards here, if that resonates for you. I mean, if it's not somebody returning, you are going to meet somebody that is your match. Okay, we saw that with the Sun and the Moon. Oh no, I'm thinking about the other pile. But yeah, I do feel there is, a very strong connection. And meditate and contemplate new moon in Pisces. So Pisces energies again, that emotions, deep emotions. I feel deep emotions coming to the surface here. And as you know, especially if it's a reunion for those of you. And if you don't resonate with that, it could be somebody new that's going to really stir those feelings in you. Okay. So beautiful energies, pile two, love and blessings. Hello, pile three, you chose the apple. So we're just going to get your oracles and then we're going to look at the tarot at the end. So we've got apple, risk and reward. Wow. And there's like a heart there. Okay, so the risk could be around love for some of you. Taking a risk in love is what I'm getting. It might be a time to take a risk in love. Taking a bite out of the apple. And if you take that risk, there's reward that will come with that, okay? So that's very powerful. And we have the owl, wise seeing, wise action. So I think they want you to know you're very wise, okay? You could have clairsentient abilities, claircognizant, clairvoyance, wise seeing, wise action. So and very strong intuition, very tapped into your intuition. And you've got wise is wisdom but within you, ancient knowing. We have the North Node, life's purpose, number four plus one, five. Five, the energy of change. So this could be you moving into your life's purpose. Maybe you were not clear, maybe you were not sure what your purpose was, or you hadn't come into that knowing or understanding. The North Node is the destiny, you know, our destiny in this life. So I feel you're heading towards that now. Maybe you've got a clearer vision, a clearer picture of where you're headed. And we've got the fire element, desire. So number 10, which is that new beginning energy. So fire element, desire. So what are you desiring? I feel that's telling you to follow your passions. What makes you feel good? What lights you up? What really stirs your passions? What makes you feel good? And it's time to do that, to follow your passions. And we have acceptance energy. I'm learning to accept the things that I cannot change. So being in that acceptance of self, you know, accepting yourself for who you truly are, you know, accepting others, accepting your situation that you're in right now, just being in that acceptance energy, just trusting, just being stepping into that flow and trusting that all will be well and knowing that there are certain things you cannot change, and having faith that things will work out. And balance energy. I bring a state of perfect balance. Sorry, I bring a state of perfect harmony into my world, and I do so without judgment. So coming into balance, it's very important that we come into balance within our own energies. You know, the masculine, the feminine, the dark, the light, the positive, the negative, to balance that out. Also, our head and our feelings. You know, our head and heart. Balance that out, not get stuck in one too long, and feel balanced in your life. You know, also, you know, in your life, like make sure you're not overworking, have a balance with home and work, not focusing on one thing, you know, having that balance of, you know, social activities and work-life balance, that sort of thing. And we have extremes, so 34-7. So maybe you are somebody who got a hot moon. So maybe you are somebody that goes from one extreme to the other in your life. Maybe you felt a bit out of control at times. This could be around emotions, feelings. Maybe you let your feelings guide you, and you didn't have, you know, didn't use logic, or you used logic too much and you didn't get in your feelings. So again, I feel that's talking about getting into balance, not being too extreme in one way of being. More in one way of being, you know, more in your feelings and less in your thoughts. Having that balance, I feel, not being extreme in your thoughts and feelings, not being extreme in actions, like taking measured action, you know, having that balance. And trust, yeah. Number 32, so another five, you know, we've got two fives. Having that trust, so trusting in yourself, you know, trusting in the universe, trusting that all will be well. And knowing that, you know, you can trust, okay, having that trust. And we've got it says egg moon. So it could be something's hatching in your life, you know, something that's gonna hatch out. As I said, we said at the beginning about taking a risk. But again, it's like having that balance, you know, knowing when to take a risk and knowing when to, like, you know, take your time over a situation or a decision. Balancing that out, I feel. And we've got growth energy, number 3-3, which is a power number. Eclipse in Sagittarius, success after a setback. So we said at the beginning about taking a risk and there will be reward. So there is growth coming towards you in your life, okay? And this is the eclipse energy. So double confirmation. So you could have been through a lot of setbacks in your life, you could have been held up. And 3-3 is like Ascended Masters number as well. So things could have been held up in your life, okay? But success is coming towards you after a setback, after things hadn't felt like they were moving forward. And we've got the High Priestess of Water number four. So feeling more grounded, feeling stable, having that firm foundation. I feel this is you getting in touch with your feelings, that emotional body. You know, really getting into your feelings to feel things more, maybe connect with your intuition more. You know, as I said, having that balance, you know, balancing out your thoughts with your feelings and tuning into your feelings, as well as using your mind, your logic. So having that balance is really going to help you. And we've got Stellar Gateway activation, infinite potential, manifestation vortex. So again, the Stellar Gateway. Above our head, you know, above the crown, connection to the divine, connection to maybe information from other dimensions, realms, beings, So you could connect with this, and there's infinite potential here, and you can help, it can help you manifest. It says manifestation vortex, so help you to manifest your desires, by really connecting with that stellar gateway. So maybe work on that in meditation or something. So we've got some final guidance at the end, so we're just going to get your tarot messages. So what else does pile three need to know? What does pile three need to know about the eclipse, lunar eclipse? We've got Four of Wands energy, so yeah, that grounded energy, building a firm foundation. And we do have a couple here. I don't know if they're making cider, but they look very cozy together. So this, you know, as I said at the beginning, you could be taking a risk around love. You could be connecting with somebody and building a firm foundation with them, you know, that could lead to a commitment. There's a couple there anyway. Oh my God, and then we have the lovers, the lady and the lord. Wow. So this is soulmate energy, and the energy of the eclipse is very much talking about relationships. Okay, so it's obviously giving this information to those of you looking. There could be a soulmate coming towards you. I'm not saying it's going to come towards you right at that time, okay, but this is your person, this is your divine person. And it's going to be mutual, you know, you know, it's destiny, North Node. I feel this is part of your North Node, part of your destiny. What else for Paul? We've got Queen of Wands energy. So this could be you really tapping into that energy, you know, that passion, that fire, as you said, you know, following your passions, feeling lit up. Maybe you've had a makeover, you're going to feel better about yourself, like a glow up. You're going to really be attracting a lot of attention, I feel. Yeah, and we've got the magician energy. So manifesting your desires, as I said, you know, using that stellar gateway portal to help you manifest your desires. So you're going to be going through a phase of really powerful manifestations, being able to manifest your desires. What else can you tell? Pile three. Can you tell pile three about the lunar eclipse? Wow, we've got Ten of Pentacles. So abundance in all areas. And the Two of Cups. Wow. So, you know, double confirmation. There definitely is a love connection coming towards you that is mutual. And it's going to lead to the Ten of Pentacles. You know, that's a partnership, living together, a home, a family, if that's what you're looking for, financial stability and abundance. Wow. Is there any other messages for pile three? Yeah, we've got that Two of Pentacles. So it's all about finding the balance. Yeah, and we've got justice. Justice is coming in, divine justice. And we have success and victory is coming towards you. Whatever you set your mind to is going to succeed. And we have the Wheel of Fortune. So the wheel is turning, it's moving forward in your favor. And yes, fast movement forward. Fast movement forward here. Okay, let's get your final guidance. Don't let the past hold you back. So we've got the South Node here. So it's time to let it go. The full moon energy is all about releasing, letting go that no longer serves you, and moving towards your North Node, your life's purpose. And I feel that's what you're going to do. You're going to be letting things go and surrender to the divine, yeah, the full moon energy. So surrendering to the divine plan, trusting, knowing that things are going to work out, and we can see there's a beautiful connection coming towards you here. I'm not saying it's going to happen exactly at this moon energy, but in the next few months, this is coming towards you. So I'm going to leave it there. If you enjoy my content, please like, share, subscribe, comment. If you'd like to win a free reading, just comment the word love down below, and I will see you next time. Bye for now.